Welcome everyone, it's Egwin from Scope of Life and Beyond Systems. Today I'm really excited because I'm starting this new video series here on YouTube. And yes, you guessed correctly, it is about emotions. This is something I haven't discussed on YouTube before, but still I think it is quite important to get to know that topic a little bit. And it's really something that can help improve your health and your overall well-being. Now, if you want to stay up to date on this series and other things that have to do with our body, with health, with well-being, and with personal development, click the subscribe button underneath. And now let's just jump right into it and discuss 9+ things about emotions that many people might not know and that can potentially change your relationship with them and how you actually deal with emotions already completely. Number one. Emotions are important for our health. Emotions are something very fundamental. They have an impact on our immune system, on our mental focus, on our sleep cycles, on our ability to regenerate and repair broken tissue, and also on our energy levels. Now, a really balanced emotional state can go a long way in being overall healthy and feeling good and well in your body and in your life in general. Number two, your emotional state determines your ability to understand and interact with others. Just picture it like that. If you are really centered in yourself, if you feel comfortable with yourself, you feel confident, you feel really energized, this gives you a much, much better foundation to actually interact and deal with everyday situations. This also allows you to have much more resources available to actually interact with other people in an empathic way, to really listen and to really allow that other opinion in. If, on the other hand, you're completely messed up at the moment because you're sad, because you're depressed or something like that, then all your resources are spent trying to fix your internal, and it's really difficult to also try and understand others outside of yourself. Number three, emotions can be really important for our survival. Now, due to their fundamental nature, whether it's in us humans or in other living beings, it's just this direct line between situations that are dangerous for us and situations where we can relax and feel good. So fear is something that's actually there to protect us. The only problem in nowadays world is that due to a lot of emotional baggage and bad experiences that some people might have had, sometimes the process is a little bit distorted and the alarm clocks go off way before there is really actual danger. This can come back and actually create troubles, but still emotions should be considered as something that is there to support us and to keep us alive. Number four, strong memories are always linked to emotions and sometimes even completely based in them. Now, whether you memorize a beautiful situation with a person you love sitting down somewhere at the beach for a sunset, or you really remember a situation that hurt you a lot, where you were depressed or where really something bad happened to you, every time you memorize something like that, it is actually partially a reliving of that situation, because emotions are so close to our physical body that the plasticity of the memory is actually created by recreating the emotion from that specific moment. Number five, emotions reflect in your posture, movement, and your muscle tone. Now, emotions are so tightly linked with ourselves, with our physical bodies, that it really shows in the way how you stand, how you walk, how you move, whether or not there is a lot of positive emotional energy going on in yourself right now, or whether you're like completely down, depressed, sad, or something like that. So this is something that in the short term is no problem at all. In the long run, if you have really strong emotions that go on for a very long time, that eventually can even have a problematic effect on body posture and body structure. Number six, emotional states are easily transferable between people. How is that, you might say? Well, think about it. If you are somewhere on the street and you look at the person even across the street walking with a smile in their face, or you just see someone in the distance, maybe 100 meters away with a smile, that instantly and subconsciously impacts you in a positive way. You sort of automatically start to synchronize to this positive expression. How strongly you do so depends on your ability to actually recognize that on a conscious level. But the influence is there all the time. The same goes for negative emotions as well. But the energy transfer of positive emotions, and yes, there is a physically measurable energy transfer, even science has proved that already, between people when there is strong positive emotions going on. So this energy transfer is a lot higher with positive emotions than it is with negative ones. And all that is a fundamental aspect of how humans synchronize with each other in order to understand each other. So this is something completely normal and regular that's happening every single day. Number seven, yes, it is possible to deal with emotions in a healthy way. And when I say deal with emotions, I definitely do not only mean control them. Control has always a very mentalized aspect to it. And when it comes to our emotions, our mind is not always the best way to deal with them. But once you understand the fundamentals, it's really easy and possible to develop a positive relationship with your emotional makeup and to actually interact with them in a positive way. Number eight, emotions are an essential part of our experiences. Now, as mentioned before, even memories are partially based in emotions. And this is due to the fact that emotions literally represent the essence of every regular day situation that we are in. Yes, there are mentalized aspects in there. There is speech, there are words that are exchanged, and so on. But it always comes down to this really intimate relationship, this how does it make you feel? How do you feel in a specific situation? And most of that is really going on a subconscious level, but it is something that's there all the time. And that makes all the difference between being a computer and being alive and being human. So that's something to embrace completely. Number nine, emotional states can be influenced through physical activity and breathing. Now, there are many different ways one can deal with emotions and influence emotions in a positive way. But the simplest ones are just getting up and moving and breathing. When it comes to breathing, yes, there are different breathing patterns that you can choose from. There are different rhythms that you can use, different breathing techniques even that one could use. But just looking at movement, it's about getting up, getting out in nature. It's about moving in terms of just going for a walk, or maybe just getting up and moving your chest area, moving your hip area, your legs. Something as simple as that already has a positive influence on emotions. Why? Because they are so tightly linked with our physical state of being. The next thing isn't really a point in itself, it's more a basic principle that stretches much further than just emotions. And it's simply the fact that whenever you know something and you know how something works, you have a much better chance of actually working with it and dealing with it in a positive way. Now, when it comes down to emotions, this literally means if you know what emotions are, if you know how they work in your body, how they come to be, this empowers you tremendously in your ability to deal with them in a positive way that actually supports you and doesn't strain you. This is something I'll be talking about a lot more in the next video. That will be the first point where we really discuss what are emotions. Right now, I hope you enjoyed the video. Give me a thumbs up if that's the case. Leave any comments and questions below. If you haven't subscribed yet, hit the subscribe button if you want to stay up to date. Other than that, I say thanks for listening in and have a wonderful time. See you soon, guys. Bye.